My name is Dr. Rod Passman. I am a professor of medicine and preventive medicine here at the Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. The use of artificial intelligence for AF management is becoming more and more important as we have a plethora of devices, both implantable and medical grade wearable devices. And then of course, these consumer devices that people can buy that can detect the rhythm of the heart, specifically atrial fibrillation. The use of artificial intelligence will be increasingly important so that we can deal with this data, adjudicate it, and respond and care for our patients in a way that we never could before. Anticoagulation and stroke prevention should always be a number one priority when treating patients with atrial fibrillation. And the good news now is that we have lots of options, not only medical therapies like the direct or novel oral anticoagulants, of course, left atrial appendage occlusion devices are growing in popularity. And we're working on a study called REACT-AF, which is using an AF sensing smartwatch to target oral anticoagulation only for brief periods of time in patients with atrial fibrillation. We're lucky that at a place like Northwestern, we have people who just specialize not only in electrophysiology, but in the care and treatment of patients with atrial fibrillation. So there's a lot of excitement in the EP community with the release of a new energy source called PFA, or pulse field ablation. As many of you know, we've been ablating atrial fibrillation now for about 25 years, typically with two other energy sources. One that uses heat in the form of radio frequency energy, and the other that uses cold in the form of cryoballoon. And while these attempts and these approaches are quite effective, there's always a safety issue and the risk of collateral damage with these thermal energies. The great advantage of PFA is that this is a safer energy source with much less or even absent risk of collateral damage to the esophagus and the phrenic nerve and other collateral structures. The threshold for recommending ablation will continue to go down. And we now have a plethora of data showing that rhythm control is preferred in the vast majority of patients. With the introduction of PFA, ablation has now become safer. And the threshold for recommending rhythm control in general, and ablation specifically, that bar continues to get lower and lower. I think it's important that physicians know that PFA is a safer approach to ablation. And whereas ablation used to be a multi-hour procedure where we were very selective in who would be a good candidate, and the procedure had some inherent risks, those risks have become much lower. The procedure has become relatively routine, and I think we need to have a more open mind and lower bar in who we recommend rhythm control in general for, and specifically who we send for ablation.